What I'm going to tell you is that, yes, we do have craft. We do have technology from somewhere else. It is an iceberg. You're seeing the tip of it that I've just started. This is an entire deployment that was swarmed by over 100 unidentified flying objects. It was gone. It wasn't just like I couldn't see it. It was no longer picked up on any of our radar systems. Where are UFOs from? Who are operating them? What is their intent? Where do they come from? I mean, this is an astounding moment in human history. This is not science fiction. This is science fact.
When Jeremy Corbell talks about UFOs, the world listens.
2, 1, boom. And we're live. Jeremy Corbell.
Joining me now is Jeremy Corbell, a UFO expert.
Investigative filmmaker Jeremy Corbell joins us live from LA.
Jeremy Corbell is an investigative filmmaker who has revealed video, testimony, and evidence that has made global headlines.
So I was intrigued as a kid when I heard on the radio in 1989, I heard Bob Lazar, this guy, talk about that he reverse engineered alien spacecraft for the United States military. And I was like, yeah. You know, I was just a kid, I was 13 years old. But then he described the propulsion system.
Totally impossible. The propulsion system is a gravity propulsion system. The power source is an antimatter reactor. This technology does not exist at all.
And that really flipped my script. For like a second, I was like, if that is true, that propulsion technique, the gravity amplified propulsion technique is true, then distance becomes irrelevant. So people can say UFOs are real, they're machines, but we don't know where they're from, but you know, maybe, hey, they're not visiting here. That's the big question. We do see them here, so they're obviously visiting here, but where are they from? With gravity propulsion, they could come from anywhere. They could come from different times. They could come from different star systems. It's really something that when you grasp it, when you grasp what that means, that there's gravity propelled craft, it opens this Pandora's box of possibilities. So that inspired me as a kid, because this is uncharted territory. How fun is that? We get to explore uncharted, unmapped territory and try to draw our own maps. I mean, there's not many things in the modern day you can't look up on Google and get a straight answer. So this is like pretty incredible. Now, I'm not a trained filmmaker. I was the least likely person you'd imagine to get access to people in our military and to put films out. But I'll tell you something, man, there was power in pointing a camera at individuals. It's like all of a sudden they're telling me stuff they never told their children. They never told their family. Secrets that they had kept for decades. And I was like, wow. So this camera became my passport into the unknown.
It's the biggest story of the 20th and 21st centuries. It's the biggest story never told.
What are your thoughts?
I'm telling you, it's not from here. This sample did not come from our solar system, much less the Earth.
Jeremy's produced and directed a number of films on the UFO phenomenon for Netflix and Hulu, each more revealing than the last. His passport into the unknown led him to speaking to military and government officials and helping them reveal their truth.
I am very grateful that I've been able to obtain and release footage unlike what the world has seen before. That is very exciting to me. If you have looked at this phenomenon for a while, you know that last year and up until 2022, George Knapp and I released a series of images and videos that were confirmed by the Pentagon as UFOs filmed by our United States military. In 2019, Navy warships got swarmed by over 100 UFOs, and I had two different ships, and I was able to obtain and release footage, not just visual cell phone footage, but also infrared footage, also FLIR, forward-looking infrared thermal footage, as well as radar data. This has never happened before. We've never had cumulative, corroborative evidence filmed by the military at this scope and scale and confirmed by the Pentagon. So let's really absorb that for a second. Is this the first time in history that we were able to get 4 to 5 sources of corroborative video, actual evidence, including radar that was filmed by our military and then confirmed by the Pentagon the corroborative nature of this evidence. I think that we can't let that get lost on people. There's a reason why we put it out at that time. We put it out at that time because there was pressure in our representative government to get answers by our intelligence agencies. And guess what? It worked. There's questions being asked. There's reports being generated. That was a huge contributory factor to that.
And that's Jeremy's mission, to catch people up by sharing evidence and testimony from those who aren't in a position to do so themselves. It's a mission he's dedicating his life to.
I am most proud of the secrets I've kept rather than the secrets that I've put out, because part of putting out secrets is people trusting that you can keep them until they're ready. What I've been able to put out was because I knew it was not against national security, that it wouldn't get people in trouble. There is a whole lot of information that George Knapp and I will be releasing as is legal and responsible. And look, not one piece of data is ever gonna be just the nail in the coffin. Even after everything that I have been exposed to, that I have seen, that I should not have seen, that I should not have been privy to, that I should not have been shown, even after that, all I have is more questions. I am more inspired by this mystery than ever, because now I don't know as much as I thought I knew when I started, man. Where are UFOs from? Who are operating them? What is their intent? I do not know the answers to the bigger questions, and I'm so excited to hopefully learn more. So I'll say, to the best of my knowledge, we have actual physical hardware from an unknown origin, which is so far more advanced than what it is that we have fabricated with our material science up to date 2022, that it is astonishing to anybody that has had the ability to be part of these exploitation programs. So with that said, I think the next revelation for everybody, you know, every country in this world, is going to be when we can see some of these materials and see how they're made. Because on a molecular or an atomic level, these alloys are incredible. They're perfectly atomically layered as if built in zero gravity. They're called metamaterials. The actual skins of these materials themselves are made of atoms that typically can't fuse together. And they're in such perfect, tiny little layers that they were somehow fabricated in a way that would be akin to atomic printing, which is not something that we can do now, but will be something that we can do in the future.